Brace, brace!
I'm bracing.
No, 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 no!
And this is Taskmaster, the modern-day equivalent of the Colosseum. But instead of swords, we use tasks. And instead of lions, we also use tasks. And rather than contestants fighting each other for a life of respect and riches, they're trying to get a rubbish trophy. It's nothing like the Colosseum. Happy now? How about you shut your sweet mouth? How about you try writing 15 series worth of intros? Too busy going for a meal with Debbie, aren't you? Huh? Yeah! I see you! Please welcome our gladiators of tasking. Frankie Boyle, Ivo Graham, Jenny Eclair, Kiell Smith-Bynoe, and May Martin. And sitting next to me, a man who confided in me that he sometimes deliberately revs his engine in traffic because it makes him feel like he's in charge of all women.
Are you ready for a brand new game show? It's called Two Lies and a Truth. Welcome, Greg, to Two Lies and a Truth. I'm going to tell you two lies and a truth. You could see if you can spot the truth. I have ridden a camel. I have ridden a zebra.
Yeah.
I have ridden a bicycle.
Yeah. I imagine you were the sort of kid who never learnt to ride a bike.
Do you think I've ridden a camel but not a bike?
That's right.
You've not made it through round one.
Bad start.
Bad start.
Prize test time! What have we got this week?
Well, Mr. Yummy Scrummy, you asked him to bring in the object which, whenever you look at it, makes you feel the weirdest.
Oh.
I feel weirdest when I look at petrol right up close for a really long time. Greg will award 5 points for the object he agrees is most likely to cause a feeling of weirdness, and the winner of the show will take home 5 objects they probably never want to look at again.
OK, Kiell, you're up first. What object have you brought in? Why will it make me feel weird?
It's a glove on a foot.
Ooh.
How do you feel?
I feel weird.
Where did you encounter this foot in a glove?
I created it.
Oh.
Although I should say, you can buy sort of latex rubber gloves, but for feet. I normally wear them. I don't know if I am. Yeah, there we go.
Oh! 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 Oh my God!
I've had them on under my socks every series, but
that's horrible.
What do you mean it's horrible?
Because you have got horribly long toes, anyway.
You could knit with those toes.
Thank you, Jenny. Thank you.
Where did you dream this up?
I knew it had to be a feet thing, because feet are weird, isn't it? Like, what are they? and then, like, rubber gloves and latex in general is just quite, like, ee.
The more I stare at it, the weirder I feel. It's a strong opener.
OK, I'll log that. Next up,
May.
I've brought in a small object that I think can trigger, like, a deep existential crisis. And that object is a mirror. And, like... what are we? Are we the meat? Are we the viewer?
Are we the meat? Are we the viewer?
One or the other. So, they did an experiment in 2010. If you stare into a mirror for 10 minutes, yeah. 66% of people experienced seeing huge deformations in their face.
I agree. I've looked into a mirror for up to 10 minutes when I was a child and I found my face to be horribly deformed.
Yeah.
And I think it works. However, if I stared at the back of that mirror, I wouldn't feel weird at all. The thing that makes you weird, I put it to you, is your own reflection, not the object you've offered up.
Interesting. I mean...
What a round!
Ivo.
I picked some magnetic detachable reading glasses.
At last!
Here they are.
There's lots that's weird about it. I'm basically throwing my uncle under the bus here. But every time he detaches his magnetic glasses, it creeps me out.
I mean, I sort of go, oh. But when I stare at the glove foot, I go, ooh.
Kiell designed that specifically for the task. He was so busy thinking about whether he could, he didn't stop to think about whether he should. But the brief of the task was whenever you look at it, it makes you feel weird. So having to look at it for 10 minutes, that's immediately invalid, whereas every time I see that, it makes me feel even a bit weird. It's winning so far as I'm concerned.
Jenny.
Greg, yes.
What did you bring in?
I bought a magic eye painting book.
Yes. The original book. There it is. And here is one of the pages from her book.
I mean, you've all seen these before, right?
It will work. You just need to look as if you're looking through the screen.
Oh, do I need to try?
Well, you can. I mean, it's... The steam train, you're right, it's a steam train.
That has made me feel weird. All right, well, great news, Frankie. I think it's very unlikely you're going to be last.
I've brought you medieval paintings of cats.
5 points.
For some reason, people in the Middle Ages couldn't paint cats properly, and it always looks really weird and disturbing.
That's from a 14th century illustrated French manuscript on Roman and Christian history.
I mean, I would argue that cats are already weird and they sort of know that they're weird.
I mean, that one's weird.
That's a guy who'd just been looking in a mirror for about 10 years and suddenly looked at a cat.
Jesus Christ, are we the meter or are we the viewer? I mean, this is unbelievable because some bloke who's bought his uncle's glasses is going to do quite well here. The least weird thing to look at on this occasion is Mae Martin's mirror. I'm sorry.
One point to make.
Yes, I can't give a magic eye painting more than a mirror. That's the truth. I can give them 1 point each.
Oh, bad luck.
Okay. Yeah. Then I jump. And then there's a big jump up, unbelievably, to Ivo's uncle's collapsible glasses. It takes 3 points. Can you imagine? Given 3 points for bringing them in. It was a diminishing return of weirdness from the cats, whereas the rubber glove on the foot made me feel consistently weird, and thus Kiell takes 5 points.
4 points to Frankie, 5 to Kiell.
Okay, let's task.
Great shout, and we begin by splitting up one of the great bands of the modern era and forcing them to go solo.
Hi.
Hi, mate.
Hi. Oh, hey.
Hi, mate.
Hiya.
Hi.
Hi, mate. All right.
Very well, thank you.
Mm. Polite young man. How old do you think he is?
41.
Unlucky.
Hello, this is exciting. I'm Jenny.
Hello, I'm Joe.
What have you got? You've got a trumpet.
Yep.
How marvellous. Do you have piles as well?
Compose a solo for this 41-year-old man. I was right. He doesn't say that. Compose a solo for this musician.
The solo must be original.
And less than 30 seconds long. That's a blessing.
You have 5 minutes.
Your time starts now.
What instrument do you play? A keyboard.
I think we will have my name and then the word Taskmaster. So what notes are in that? I-V-O.
None.
No. G-A, another A. And then in Taskmaster, it's quite A heavy, isn't it?
Hit that one.
Oh, I love that.
A, 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 A.
Is there any sort of rhythm with that?
Yeah, jaunty.
Jaunty.
Instead of playing it with your hands, you play it with your feet?
Shoe off?
Yeah, shoe off, okay. Definitely.
What I'll do is I'll just sing some notes and you just follow it, OK? La 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 la! Loo loo loo!
Na 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 na!
better?
And then I will guess how old you are. You'll know when it's the right number.
I think I might.
Yeah, I love that.
Good.
I don't want anything more than that.
Terrific. Can I take that task off you, Frankie? And can I swap it for that one?
Oh.
While you're here, I mean that as well.
Make something that looks like this musician's musical instrument.
Then mime to your new solo.
You may not use a musical instrument in the creation of your musical instrument.
Best performance wins.
I've got 15 minutes in my time, Joe. Starts
Has it started
now.
Yet?
It started now.
There's the hi-hat right there. How long's the drumstick, mate?
Bloody hell, yes, it's more complicated than you think. Mine's less complicated than you.
Four strings, is it?
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
How many keys does it have?
25, I'd say.
25? Would you settle for 7?
Yours isn't quite as big as mine.
Oh, is that what we're doing?
Quite like accuracy.
Unbelievable.
Pretty good. Oh, finished?
Yeah.
Okay.
Jenny, we frequently go south of the waistband with you, I've noticed. I didn't know that trumpet players do get piles.
Oh, yes.
You did what then seemed to be an extreme scat.
I'm so unmusical. I don't even recognise Happy Birthday. It's like something I can't do.
I don't recognise Happy Birthday.
You know when people start singing Happy Birthday and they expect you to join in? And I panic.
Because... The cake must give you a clue.
OK, I'm not going to let you see any of their solos until after the break. And if that's not enough of a tease, well, here's a little bit of my leg. Hello! Welcome back to Taskmaster. It's part two, Alex.
Thank God for you, Greg.
Amen.
Before the break, our cast used 5 brilliant musicians to create original solos and then found they had to mime to their solo on an instrument they'd made to look like the real musician's instrument. First up, with the voice of an angel, projected through a banana-based trumpet, it's Jenny Eclair.
I'd like now to play for you a solo piece called the Ni 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 Na Na song. And give me a one, give me a two, give me a one, two, three. Thank you very much. I think I might have piles now.
Felt it was a powerful performance. I think it's a beautiful instrument.
Could you convince yourself that it was Jenny making those noises?
If I gobbled a dish full of recreational drugs, I could convince myself that was Jenny Eclair playing that instrument, and indeed that instrument was functional.
You want another one?
Yes, please.
OK, next up, with a dramatic drum solo, it's Frankie Boyle.
Drum solo on a count of 4. A 1, a 2, a 3, 4! I have no real memory of doing that.
Your face said at the end, I think this has gone badly. But I thought it was quite good. I'm a bit worried because I'm just enjoying all these. Who's next?
Well, there's still time. It's now time for a man who simply oozes sax appeal, Ivo Graham.
Welcome to the Taskmaster Jazz Festival. It's Ivo Graham with Toxic Gold Fumes, brackets, mainly in A. Take it away. Thank you.
very much enjoyed your instrument. I enjoyed the keys, all seven of them.
Yes.
The colour. I enjoyed your performance very much.
Let's leave the sentence there, I say.
Okay. Next.
All right, well, now it's time for Mae Martin on the double bass with the toe.
I'm so excited to present my original solo by Mae Martin. Maestro. Maestro, am I right? Sorry, I don't want to lose points for Maestro.
It's too late.
Okay. One, two, three, four.
So while we were watching that, you were disturbed by the sight of your own toe.
It doesn't look like that. My foot does not look like that.
Does it not?
No, very dainty, sexy. Just trust me.
You know what you need, don't you? pop a glove on that.
They're like fingers, they spread too.
See what I mean? Feet, what are they?
Yeah, yeah.
How are they? Right, one left.
Yes, it's our final solo. It's keyboard KL.
One, two, three, and... Composer solo, less than 30 seconds, composer solo. Less than 30 seconds, composer solo. Less than 30 seconds long, they're long, they're 30 seconds long. What's your age, young man? 41, 42, 43.
Thank you, Kiell.
That's all right. Yeah. I sort of felt I couldn't look away from it, but I also found it quite unsettling.
Sexy, though, right?
So sexy.
Yeah.
I'm 54, by the way.
I'll do you a song later.
Oh, Christ, that is so hard. I enjoyed all of them. But I'm going to give Kiell, Ivo and Jenny 5 points. Ooh. And I'm going to give Frankie and Mae 4 points.
Oh?
I've literally lost my goddamn mind.
Right. Well, there we go. It's 5 points to Jenny, Kiell and Ivo.
Hooray!
Scoreboard time.
Yes, it is. Last week's winner is in last place. Mae's got 5. Kiell has 10 points in the lead at the moment.
What's next, Alex?
Well, Greg, it's the first team task of the series.
Hi.
Hello, May.
A potato.
Excellent.
Thanks.
Please, can you put that down?
Yeah.
You can pick up the potato.
Okay.
Right.
Hello.
Okay.
Hello. I'm so sorry. I can only hold down.
What are you talking about? No way.
It's lovely. Oh, thank you. Why have you got a large potato?
I brought it from home.
Oh, good. I wish I bought one.
We've got
jackets in the garden. Sometimes with a potato, you can smell when they're on the turn.
Yeah.
But look, we have another friend.
Hello.
Yo. What's that then?
Hey.
You all right?
Yeah, how are you?
Well, good, you? Yeah?
Would you like to hold the potato?
I'd love to.
There you go. Enjoy.
Thank you.
Hello, Frankie.
All right, man. I've got a potato.
Hello, Alex.
Here. Hello, Ivo.
Sorry to interrupt you about the potato.
Build the highest bridge over the middle of the red-green. Right, I'll start again.
Build the highest bridge over the middle of the red-green.
And balance the potato on the middle of the bridge.
The potato may not be anchored in any way.
If anything touches the red-green, you must put everything back where you found it.
Tut, and go back to the drawing board.
You have 20 minutes.
Your time starts now.
I can do the tutting. I'll just stand here and get ready to tut.
As the clever one, you start planning and I go and get a whole load of random shit.
The first thing Frankie's done is send me away.
The team of three seem very comfortable together straight away.
Good chemistry.
Good chemistry. Mm. What's going on here, do you
think? I didn't know he... I thought it was some bloke delivering something.
So you didn't know who Ivo was?
I did once I, like, fully took him in, but I thought someone's just wandered into the shop.
I would say, watching Frankie and Ivo, they were the most like a sort of father and son team we've ever had, except a father and son who haven't really spent any time together.
It's what you want from the team task. The crackle of tension. Not some bloody mic-muffling hug. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. We all sniff a potato and then get on. Boring!
Not for me and my dad.
Do you want to see the boring team of three first?
Yeah, let's get them out of the way, being all nice to each other, and we can get on to this fucking shit show.
Here we see Jenny, Kiell and May.
Gather stuff. Right, come on, okay. Gang.
I'm getting different stuff.
Oh, no, that isn't what.
There looks like there's shit on this one. Do you want it as high as possible? Barrel on top of barrel. Get it high. Oh, I'm loving
Wait,
your work.
Wait, everyone stop. I touched the red green.
Please put everything back, tut, and go back to the
No.
board.
I'm so...
Why did you tell them? Why did you tell them?
We have to tut.
Please be careful, Johnny. Don't do yourself...
No, don't stop patronising me.
OK. Back to the drawing board, please.
Touch the drawing board.
Has it? I think you may have just touched it.
I did, yeah.
Oh, a tut.
Back to the drawing board.
You think too blue?
Too blue. Barrels on top. It's got to be as tall as possible.
I think the best way we're going to do it is with duct tape.
Yeah, do you think we can get higher than it?
Yes.
Is the pole taller than these at the moment?
Like that?
Yeah, we can.
Okay, okay. So we just need duct tape. We have a new plan.
I'm putting this down. Fuck okay. that. Why don't we make this wider?
3.5 minutes.
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
Ooh, no.
2:20.
Careful.
I can't bear it.
Okay, slow raise at the same time.
Come on, magic potato, up to the sky, up to the sky.
Stop the clock, I think.
I think we could go higher.
No, I'm scared.
I'm coming round to help, May.
Oh, careful.
Come on. Come on, higher.
OK, stop the clock.
Higher.
No.
Higher, stop the clock now.
You want me to measure it?
Yes.
OK, lovely stuff.
Oh, well done. Super teamwork. Oh. No, don't let it touch.
First things first, let's see a clip of Jenny getting rid of that plank again.
Here she is.
Yep.
Fuck that.
Yeah. She did say at one point, it's like a day out with your nana, but quite a weird nana.
You got the magic potato up to the sky, and I think you're a lovely team.
Yeah, they did pretty well. They got about the same height as, if you imagine, the average three-year-old standing on the shoulders, or the head, actually, of maybe a taller than average 10-year-old or an average 11-year-old. That's about that. That's two.
How high was it?
2.40 meters, sorry.
Right then, everyone, we're halfway through the show. Alex, run me a bath and then get your scrubbing brush. Let's see if we can't get some of this dead skin off. Three of Taskmaster, where I'm now as smooth as an eel.
Yes, we got it all off. We got it all off.
Mm.
The current task involves trying to make the highest bridge to support a potato, but if anything touches the red-green, it's quite salty. They have to put everything back where they found it, tut, and go back to the drawing board. We've seen the team of three build and tut. Now let's see Frankie and Ivo work together as a pair.
Do you want some chalk?
Yes, I would, please. I don't actually, you know, I don't want to come across as too much of a snowflake, but I don't enjoy the sensation of chalk on a chalkboard.
Ah.
Oh, I like this, those.
This might inspire something.
I haven't done much with the board yet. I think I'd probably like to borrow a board brush, a board clearer, a dusting tool. A lot of pressure on Frankie, I think.
What's your idea?
Well, I've certainly cleared the board.
My idea, right? Maybe a bad idea.
Yeah, good.
We just try and go from the top of the caravan to the top of that kind of geodesic dome, and we stick the potato in the middle.
To the top of what? The geo...
Well, geodesic dome. It's
the
probably...
the geodesic right? dome.
Yeah. Great. That little greenhouse.
Great.
It's really the opposite of the shape we need. Well, that's an ugly start.
It certainly makes you think about what could be achieved closer to the...
Yeah. Hello.
Yeah.
That's lower than the ladder.
That's lower than the ladder.
Well, I think we should abandon that and move nearer the thing. OK, don't drop that.
Can we be in there?
Yeah, we can be human parts of the bridge. Nothing says we can.
Yes! I'm going to have a bit of a rootle around the house.
We could roll it in a tube. Mate.
The second ladder. Frankie!
Yeah. Perhaps we should have done more work in our planning phase.
I think skipping the planning was thrilling.
Now measure the blighter.
Yes, yes. I don't really know how to measure it.
What's the matter, Alex? Can't reach our spud.
There we go.
Very happy with that. Well done, Ivo. I'm going to let this go now.
This is like a 1970s sitcom. People from a different class. I'm the Lord, but he's the master.
I feel, despite what might seem like differences between us, I've got nothing but love for Mr. Ivo Graham. And I felt that most of the success of the task was due to Ivo prompting me to be less wrong.
A really genuinely sweet thing that somehow still sounded like a threat. Yeah. How high did they go, though?
It was as high as Hagrid jumping over a loaf of bread. Well, he's 2 metres 59. 2 metres 81. 41 centimetres higher than the team of three.
Well, they were both fairly effective, weren't they?
Yes, but there must be a gulf.
Yeah, 5 and 3.
OK, so 3 points to the team of three, 5 points to Daddy and Son.
Daddy and Son! Let's have a rootle around and see if we can get another task.
Yes, here we go. Deep breath.
Kiell, Hazard, watch this.
How'd you do that?
Uh-huh.
That was cool.
Thank you. Oh, I went...
Did that not work?
No, we're going to go the other way up. All right, Chief. Are you ready?
Oh, yeah.
Achieve the most impressive effect with a single breath.
You must take your breath and achieve your effect within the next 20 minutes.
The most impressive effect. Effect.
Blowing out a candle. Not in itself very impressive, but perhaps if it achieved complete darkness within a space, that would be quite boring and bad television.
I need to find a dying frog or a tiny bird that I can give mouth-to-mouth resuscitation to.
Is it raining?
No.
All right, come on then.
Is this the first time in 15 series of this show that we've been asked for a dying frog?
Second time.
Well, I'm very keen to see the impressive effect that these people did with a single breath.
Oh. Lovely. OK, up first, it's May and Kiell.
Hello again.
Hi. This is just phase one.
So we need some pipes, a couple of bricks. This is going to be incredible.
I've never worked so hard in my life.
Right, you put a mop on a duck on a shed.
Yes.
You've got 4 minutes, May.
Oh, my God.
Ah! That's not even science, man.
I'm going to blow it down, one huge breath, and then hopefully it's going to hit the xylophone.
That's the end. That'll be the... Ah!
Oh, my God.
Good luck, Kiell.
Ah!
Ready?
Good luck.
Don't fail me, OK?
You ready?
I'm ready.
Are you ready? They're ready.
I'm going to blow this with a single breath.
Someone's going to say that that was going to be more impressive than what I did. And I'm going to kick off.
Hey, I think you're fast becoming an expert at these tasks.
Oh, thank you.
They beaver away, they create something.
Beaver away famously.
Great beavering and...
Thank you.
And what a lovely pipe at the end of it as well.
There was a real contrast between the two.
Oh, come on!
What Kiell's very good at is having the confidence of someone who's doing a good job. Your self-belief is sensational.
I didn't really take into consideration that I'm not able to blow a golf ball.
Oh, no, stuff went wrong way before that.
Next up are two comedians known simply as Jenny Eclair and Frankie Boyle.
Hello, Jenny.
Hello, Alex. I'd like to show you my party trick. The most impressive thing I can do with a single breath is save this caravan.
Right, here is it.
Yeah. You just need to be ready to duck.
I'm ready to duck.
I'm going to save this caravan from a roaring inferno.
Jenny? Jenny?
I saved the caravan!
Is it definitely out?
Yeah.
Was it one breath?
One breath.
Can I just check, can we stand down all the fire officers now?
Slightly over the top, wasn't it?
There's a lot of them. Thank you, Jenny.
Thank you.
single breath.
Do you think it was impressive?
It would have been impressive if they'd let me really set fire to the curtains, but they were being a bit wet about it.
Yeah, so it is their fault. But really, it was just you blowing on the corner of a curtain.
She saved the caravan, no doubt about it. If she hadn't blown it out,
it would have been a blazing inferno.
Yeah. Why was I so impressed by Frankie Boyle being a naughty boy?
Everyone hates golf.
Everyone.
I've never really played golf because I'm not trapped in a loveless marriage.
Frankie got slightly lucky because our garden backs onto a golf course. Your first instincts were to blow a whistle in a matinee or a church.
Both of which I would have enjoyed. OK, one par left until someone wins a glove that Kiell put on a foot. Feel the rush! Welcome back to Taskmaster. We've got a task that needs completing, and Alex is about to fill you in on why.
Yes, the comedians have been trying to achieve the most impressive effect with a single breath. There's only one person left to see, and it's Ivo!
Can I try and get on the radio and just breathe?
Yeah, that's impressive.
Yeah. When I'm speaking to the producer, I'm a bit more like, yes, I've got an opinion about wind farms, but then... once I'm on the air. Five live.
Yeah, you've got...
Yeah, I know.
12 minutes.
They've just hung up. I'll instead call... Greg.
Will he recognise your breath?
Hello, I'm sorry, but the person you called...
No!
That's agony. That's agony. I will breathe down the phone today. All right.
3.5 minutes, my boy.
Yeah. I'd like to apologise for the willful damage of fancy glassware. I call Ed Gamble, previous Taskmaster contestant, winner and host of the Taskmaster podcast.
Hello, Ivo.
Is Ed still on the line?
No, I hung up. It feels like one point, doesn't it?
I mean, the whole attempt is extraordinary.
The trouble is nothing happened. It was a single breath, and the single breath, it had no effect at all.
My instinct is to say Ivo gets one point, but then I remember Jenny blowing on the corner of a curtain. I'm going to give them both one point.
So you're giving Jenny... fewer points than Kiell.
Hey, 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 look, don't bring me in here. He's having a nice time over here. Let him do his thinking.
He blew at a golf ball three times and nothing happened.
Hey, hey, hey.
No, but he constructed a thing.
I can't believe what's going on here.
I need to report from the front line and it was very disappointing.
Yeah, the first three, and then the fourth one was fucking sick.
Yeah, but it was a single breath, Kiell.
Do you know what it is? I've been hypnotised by your charm. And I was about to give you 2 points when you don't deserve them.
Alex! Oh,
thank God my little assistant's here. So you can have 1 point as well.
Shit's sake!
Oh. 1 point...
Mine is the same. The same?
Yeah.
I don't know where that finger's pointing.
1-1-1.
I mean, I've got to say, I'm not especially impressed. With any of these.
Right, OK.
What about me? What about the bing at the end?
Bing was good. But is it a 5-point bing?
Yeah.
I don't think it's a 5-point bing.
Are you sure you just haven't become jaded with the concept of the show?
I don't think that's the case.
We haven't got a 5-point bing, and I can't give a grown man putting a golfer off 5 points.
Who wins the task, Greg.
OK, May wins the task. And I've already told you it wasn't a five-point bing, so logic would tell you that May gets 4 points and Frankie gets three.
OK, so well done, May. You sort of won the task. 4 points! Kiell, are you all right?
I'm fuming.
One last look at the scores.
At the top of the pile, it's Frankie Boyle with 16 points. Wow.
OK, it's time to leave your seats and head to the stage for, guess what, the final task of the show! I'm already excited.
Oh, yes.
Who's going to read it out?
Ivo Graham this time.
Ah.
Create a recognisable picture of an animal on the back of your T-shirt using the equipment provided. You must stay on your spot and you must not move your spot. If you create the same animal as someone else, you will both be disqualified. Best recognisable picture of an animal on your back wins. You have 200 seconds.
Put an animal on your back. If it's the same animal as someone else, you get nothing.
Good luck. Your time starts. What sort of animals are you hoping for, Greg?
Baboon. Hedgehog.
OK. So I'll remember on the backs of your T-shirts. We've got halfway.
Bless you, darling. That's very
it.
Kind.
That's all we need. In terms of audience interaction, one woman shouting, go on, Jenny.
Do you want the same woman to shout anything again?
They could encourage a different contestant.
No, yeah. That's...
35 seconds left now, Greg. Not long.
I mean, Kiell completed his about 2 full minutes ago.
Frankie is also finished. Eight, seven,
feel great,
six, five, four, three, two. Please put down your materials. First to reveal their animal, it's going to be Frankie Boyle. Are you ready to witness his animal?
I'm absolutely beside myself. Unmistakably rigid shape of a deceased snake.
Frankie, is that what you were trying to achieve?
Yes.
Yes.
If there's one thing you famously say about snakes, they are straight.
A lot of different kinds of snakes, Greg.
Can we see the second animal?
OK, Ivo, please turn around and show us your animal. Bearing in mind that Ivo was the only person who discovered the scissors.
So I don't love what that implies.
What animal is it, Greg?
I think it's a jaunty giraffe.
I aimed for jaunty and I'm glad that's been recognised.
Is it a giraffe?
Oh, yes.
Jenny Eclair, what do we have?
Butterfly.
Butterfly.
And it's really
they
good.
All like it.
This is Jenny's finest hour.
Are we ready for Kiell's?
Kiell used 30 seconds of his allotted time.
Oh, dear. No.
This seems very cruel. But sadly, it's another snake.
It could be a stick insect.
Is it a snake, Kiell?
It's a bendy snake.
Fair point.
Frankie and Kiell were first and second in the episode.
Cruelly disqualified.
Both now out.
OK, May. Oh, my God, that's good.
Why is that so good?
It's not just a bit of tape stuck on a board, Kiell. That's why it's good. I think it might be an extinct bird.
A dodo?
It is an owl. But sure, it's enough to say it's a bird.
Yeah, it's a duck. It's a bird.
It's a bird. It's a bird. What counts.
OK.
Two snakes bite the dust. Who'd have thought that the heel-clicking jaunty giraffe would get 3 points? And yet there it is, 3 points to the giraffe. And honestly, they're both very good, but for me, Jenny's beautiful butterfly just takes it. So 4 points to May and 5 points to Jenny Eclair, and that's an end to it.
OK, there we go. Well done, Jenny Eclair.
Come down, we'll see how that's affected the final scores.
Well, that's got to put the old proverbial cat amongst the pigeons, hasn't it?
It really has. And none of them made cats or pigeons. They made beautiful animals.
Yes, they did.
Unfortunately, there were two snakes. The final scores are so close. There's only 3 points separating the five of them. Frankie and May are in joint second place, but the winner with 17 points, Ivo Graham.
Ivo Graham wins! Please leap up to look at your objects and feel weird. So, what have we learned today? We've learned that if your husband's back late from a round of golf, he's not necessarily having an affair. His swing might have been impeded by Frankie Boyle's whistle. That's all for now. Four people didn't win this week, but one definitely did. And you know who it was? I know. It was Ivo Graham! Bye!
Now, just because you can be an estate agent doesn't always mean that you should. Catch Kiell in the multi-BAFTA-winning comedy Staff Let's Flat, streaming on all four now. Now, here on Channel 4 next, for the very first time, the grafters have the power, and you can bet they're going to use it. There's a revolution going on in Rise and Fall on the way.